nice to see you, my young friend.
Seems a pleasant enough little place.
Handy resource indeed, your field guide. I'm most pleased to be included.
The student who ran all those goblin loyalists off. I can't tell you what a relief that was to everyone in Lower Hogsfield.
Hello, Mr. Semi.
What can I do for you?
What do you have for sale?
What can I help you with today? Ah, yes, a wonderful choice.
Hope to see you again sometime.
Revelio. Confringo!
Off on another adventure, are we? What are you up to now? Revelio.
Professor, what made you want to teach herbology?
How lovely of you to ask. I've always had an affinity for greenery, so this situation is a bit of a dream come true. After graduation, I was thrilled to be asked to step in for my old herbology professor. He'd had a slight accident, you see.
Oh dear. A shame for him, but it worked out well for you.
Well, he never cared. Really cared for the plants, and they could sense it. Oh, you'd be surprised how perceptive a plant can be. At any rate, the trouble began one day when he cut into a wigan tree.
Unfortunately for him, its leaves were hiding a bow truckle. You may recall the marvelous creatures that resemble a twig. The little beast gouged the professor's eyes quite fiercely, but terrifying, I'd imagine. Likely for the professor, too.
And that's when you took over as the herbology professor?
Well, not quite. After 3 weeks at St. Mungo's, my predecessor regained a tiny bit of his eyesight. He insisted on returning to the greenhouse. Within a week, he claims, by accident, kicked a Chinese chomping cabbage, so it was back to St. Mungo's for him.
What a string of bad luck.
Well, I felt awful for him, but I dare say I felt a bit more sympathy for the cabbage. Upon his discharge from the hospital, his indifference to plants had turned to utter disdain. He lost what little patience he had left with a particularly temperamental venomous tentacula and, well, his resulting leave of absence continues to this day.
I'm glad everything worked out as it did and that you're the herbology professor now.
Very kind of you to say. I do love these gardens and helping my students grow. Lovely speaking with you. Have a wonderful day. Oh, and remember, be kind to your Wigan trees.
Sometimes it seems all roads lead to Hogsmeade.
Hello there, come on in. Plenty to look at here. A pleasure doing business with you. Let me know if there's anything else I can do to help.
Revelio. Does it get any more cozy than Hogsmeade?
Handy resource indeed, your field guide. I'm most pleased to be included.
Thank you again for delivering those cushions to my wow. It's going to be a lot of time and trouble.
Ugh.
Greetings. Please, take your time looking about.
Revelio.
Let me guess. You're after something fresh. No one can say I don't keep a stacked shelf.
Revelio. Revelio. Revelio.
Nice to see you, my young friend.
Just let me know if there's something in particular you're looking for. Nothing like finding just the right thing, is there? Let me know if there's anything else I can do to help.
Hogsmeade, here I come.
Także jest co robić, oczywiście zdalnie ja włączyłem sobie mikrofon i dopiero teraz się tak nawet żeby to było gdzieś pół godziny, bo czego by i nie. No, tu mnie jeszcze nie było.
Right out of a story.
Shane Bardolph thought dark magic was the answer. I reckon Rookwood's played a hand in his disappearance. Off on another adventure, are we?
Brownrot's loyalists are a menace. What can be done?
I couldn't help but overhear. Did you mention Ranrock's loyalists?
I did. Never imagined they'd act this deadly. I'm Claire Beaumont, by the way.
Nice to meet you.
Ranrock and his followers have set up camp here. No regard for our beloved hamlet or our livelihoods. Ruthless. My brother Bardolph dared to stand up to them and ended up in St. Mungo's. I'm simply at my wit's end.
How did your brother Bardolph end up in St. Mungo's?
Bardolph had spent the entire day handpicking herbs and roots for us. When a group of Ranrock's lot appeared and demanded the harvest for themselves, Bardolph refused. In their anger, they hurled him against a rock and robbed him. The moment he left St. Mungo's, he vowed revenge. I worry he may be dabbling in magic that he will one day regret.
You said Ranrock's loyalists have set up camp here. Where, precisely?
To the south, across the river. Last I heard, there were several loyalists in each camp. I won't go near them.
I'm unfortunately quite familiar with Ranrock's loyalists. Perhaps I can do something.
Much as I would love to be rid of them, I wouldn't want you to risk injury, or worse. Please be cautious. We should not have to live in fear. This is our home.
It seems as though things are getting worse. Best be on my guard. Revelio! Revelio. Seems a pleasant enough little place.
You don't ever want to find
I remember you. Your generosity helped me afford this rather exotic snake contraption.
Very sad, keeping away from today's young.
Revelio. Revelio. One of Ranrock's camps, exactly as Madame Beaumont described. You've one less follower, Ranrock. One camp down, one more to go.
Such Revelio.
Who lived here, I wonder?
There's a grapple on you.
Let me see.
Both camps cleared. Madame Beaumont will be glad to hear that. Abandoned long ago, no doubt. I wonder who lives here.
I do miss the bustle.
Hello, Madame Beaumont. Good news. I was able to clear out Ranrock's camps.
You cleared them out? How?
I managed to catch them off guard.
When my brother returns, this news will mean the world to him. You saved our hamlet, my young friend. This will not be forgotten. I fear for other hamlets, truly. Ranrock and his lot are unlike any goblins I've ever seen.
What do you have for sale?
What are you looking for exactly? Thank you. Sincerely. Oh, you like that? A fine choice.
Thank you.
Revelio. Depulsa.
Mind. Jason, I don't know.
Hello, Mr. Semi.
What can I do for you?
What do you have for sale?
What can I help you with today? Ah, yes, a wonderful choice. I hope to see you again sometime.
I know what that means. Merlin trial. Confirm. Depulsa. Expelliarmus. Levioso.
also.
Yes, but if we had a round of gobstones in the common room, it'd save us catching cold outside.
I'd wager the Hufflepuff common room's the coziest of them all. Simply the fact that it's so close to the kitchens makes it seem more homely.
Levioso!
Dobra, powiem wam, że chyba mi dzisiaj na dzisiaj starczy.
Handy resource indeed, your field guide. I'm most pleased.
What seems to be the problem?
You may well ask. I'm convinced I saw a Grimm, an omen of death. I'm not safe, but if it can't see me, I'll be all right, won't I? All I need is an invisibility potion. Yes, that's what I need.
The Grimm, if you saw one, is an omen. Omens don't attack you. So I doubt an invisibility potion will do you much good.
I can see you don't believe me. Fine. Then my blood will be on your hands. No kindness in the youth of today.
Revelio.
Ah, but a purse made of unicorn skin. That fetches a few gallons.
Dobra, dostał tego kota. Zostaw kota. Masz swoje dwa. No. Mendy jedno super to takie, że nie wiadomo.
Revelio.
They think I'll see. Can't figure out why there's such a fuss of.
Levioso! Would you like me to put you down? I'll bet that one.
Levioso!
Revelio. Ah!
attack you.
Revelio. Revelio. Hello. Do you have anything for sale?
That I do. But what's a student like yourself doing out here? Got yourself lost, did you?
Just exploring the countryside a bit.
Aye. Nice to break the routine now and then. Bit of a wanderer myself, in fact. Name's Leopold Babcock, and I am indeed here to sell. Now, for someone like yourself who is also prone to wander, I cannot understate the importance of keeping some Wiganweld potion on hand. I wouldn't dare set foot in a place like the Forbidden Forest without a steady supply. What do you say, my young friend? A measure of safety for the path ahead?
Something to consider. Thank you for your help, Mr. Babcock.
Aye, let me know if you see something you like.
What do you have for sale?
See if there's something you need.
Yes, my brother. Yes.
Thank you for your patronage. That's been a pleasure.
No, I swear I won't be wasting your time, and I'm grateful for the opportunity, ever so.
Come on, then. What you got?
It's
like it moving.
What, I bet?
Your bag is everything.
No, it's a niffler!
What do I want with a niffler?
He's sharp. Stole from me, he did.
He was robbed by a niffler.
That's what I'm saying. He's a natural, worth his weight in galleons.
Go on, then. Show him to me.
Revelio. Depulsa. Accio. Potato. Accio. Accio! Depulso! Expelliarmus! Confringo! Depulso! Confringo! Expelliarmus! Revelio.
Что мама будет мне кушать, да? На похварту. Мы покушаем. И сделаем это питание. Все скажем.
Wonderful.
Imagine how inconvenient travel was before I invented flu powder.
See if there's something you need.
Nie to kupię. Humora i Astra. Nie wiem gdzie to jest. Nie mam pojęcia.
That's been a pleasure.
I na razie kończę ten odcinek.